A very good morning to all of you. Ministers, dear colleagues, dear friends, a very good morning to all of you. And today, I thought after this all very impressive speeches we heard from the political leaders, from the business community, and others, I give an X-ray of the global energy situation where we are today. Some numbers here. I have only 6 slides to show you where we actually are and how critical is the action today. We are at the IEA, we are very fortunate. We have all the energy data at our fingertips. And at the end of every year, or beginning of the following year, we look at how did the global energy system behave. And when we look at the year 2018, last year, ladies and gentlemen, what we have seen is the global energy demand last year increased the highest in the last decade. Very strong growth of global energy demand. Why? Because global economy increased very strongly. Now the question is, which fuels did contribute to this growth? Are those fuels that we would like to see, or some others? When we look at the picture, we see that almost half of that growth of global energy demand was coming from natural gas, followed by renewables, followed by oil and others. This is what happened in the year 2018. About 70% of the energy demand was met by fossil fuels last year. What are the implications of that for the CO2 emissions? We all want to see decline of the CO2 emissions. All the political leaders said action, action, action. What does action mean? Reduction of emissions. What the United Nations told us, 1.5 degrees, which means big decline of the emissions. But I look at the numbers. When I look at the numbers, year 14, 15, 16, at least there was a flat. Emissions didn't increase. But last year, when I was here, I told you that 17, we have seen another increase of emissions. And I asked myself and to you here last year, I hope 2018 numbers would be better. But I can show you that the 2018 global emissions hit a historical high. So what worries me, ladies and gentlemen, there is a growing disconnect between political statements, targets, and what is happening in the real life. This is very important, and we shouldn't be taken with the very attractive way of talking about the trends and all of this. Is what we want to see is different, but what is happening is different. We have to acknowledge what is happening today. And here, the biggest driver of the emissions last year was coal generation in the world. 1/3 of the CO2 emissions came from coal generation, and as such, it is the largest source of emissions, even higher than land use. Something to take note of. Now, we also look at the electricity demand. Global electricity demand is growing very strongly. Energy demand increases, but electricity demand increases 2 times higher than the energy demand. Very strong. And the question is, Where does the generation come from? And again, in the year 2018, we saw that the renewables, especially solar and wind, made big inroads, mainly as a result of declining costs. Excellent news. Renewables are getting cheaper and cheaper. Having said that, it covers renewables, together with hydro and others, only half of the growth in the electricity generation. Other half from something else. Therefore, there's a lot of work to do for my dear colleague, Francesco La Camera, who is an excellent leader for IRENA, who is a wonderful colleague to work with us, to work with the IEA, to make the renewables growth even stronger. Now, ladies and gentlemen, you may want to know, renewables are growing, we are telling it all the time. What is the share of different fuels in the world? Now, when you look at the picture, it is really different than our speeches. Today, about 40% of the electricity generation in the world comes from coal, followed by gas and others, which means still two-thirds of the electricity generation comes from fossil fuels. And the share of solar and wind put together is still lower than 10%. Put the things in a context. So a lot of work to do here. Despite the declining costs, please, 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 let's put the things in a context to understand the real dimensions of the challenge we have in front of us. Now, renewables are growing. They will grow because of they are getting cheaper, and many governments, such as in Germany, giving a lot of support to that. But not only Germany, but many countries around the world. So, this is good news, but there is only one challenge, at least one, which is solar and wind, their availability is bound by the nature, by the weather conditions. So the issue is, how do we integrate the solar and wind in the electricity systems so that we don't have accidents and we integrate them in the most economic way? When we look at the countries one by one, the share of solar and wind in the electricity generation, if it is less than 10%, it doesn't pose a major challenge, major problem. Because with the existing system, you can accommodate them within the electricity systems. But when their share increases, such as the one in, for example, in Germany or in European Union in general, about 25%, now you have to be careful. You have to be careful how to integrate them in the electricity systems without creating any challenges if there is no wind or if there is no sun. So therefore, we need to invest in the systems which make our power generation, power transmission and distribution much more flexible. And we know that the share of renewables will increase. We hope that the share of renewables will increase. And this challenge will be even much more pronounced. It is a major, major issue. So, ladies and gentlemen, for the governments, you may think there is only one homework to increase the share of renewables. This is only one. There is the other one, to integrate the renewables in the systems in the right way and create flexibilities in the systems. Otherwise, we may well have some difficulties for the renewables, which are extremely important for our fight against climate change. This is a major issue, and the German government and the International Energy Agency are organizing a high-level event in Berlin and here, 27th of September, to look at the implications of system integration. Together with renewables, we have another bedrock to fight against climate change, which is energy efficiency. Mr. Kaiser already mentioned the critical importance of energy efficiency, and we at the IEA look at every year how the energy efficiency patterns look like. To be honest with you, once again, I have bad news. Global energy efficiency improvement 2018 got weaker. We wanted to see even higher than previous years, but it got weaker. Why? Policies in many countries are getting weaker, and the lower energy prices also gave an input to see low energy efficiency patterns. This is very worrying. This is very worrying. The energy efficiency doesn't get the attention that it deserves from the governments and others. I want to give you one example, building sector. Buildings, ladies and gentlemen, today in the world are responsible about one-third of the global CO2 emissions, one-third, what we consume energy and emit CO2 emissions in the buildings. And with the support of German government, we are releasing a report today. Our director, Mrs. Wurstorfer, is going to talk about it, about the buildings. I can give you one number which is very, very worrying, at least for me. Today, as we speak now, 2 out of 3 buildings built in the world, constructed in the world, has no building codes and efficiency standards. 2 out of 3. And these buildings will be with us 50, 60 years and waste a lot of energy. So, how can we, without efficiency improvements, solve this challenge without having stronger efficiency standards is a critical question. My last slide is perhaps for me the most important one, because in the terms of climate change, I consider this issue as a blind spot of the international climate change debate. When it comes to climate change, we talk about the new renewable plants, efficiency, and others. But there is one very important issue that I believe not discussed, and it is perhaps for the numbers, it is the most important one, which is the following. With the current national determined contribution, current policies, the world is perfectly on track to a temperature increase close to 3 degrees Celsius, which will definitely change the rather fragile equilibrium of our planet. But what we all want to see to bring the temperature increase in line with the Paris Agreement. Now, I asked my colleagues to do an heroic work. I told them the following. Leave aside what we are building now, what we will build in the future. The existing energy infrastructure today, power plants, factories, buildings, how much CO2 they will emit in the next 25 years, existing infrastructure, and how much of the budget allowed us in Paris, they are going to eat up, how many percent of that? With the existing funds, forget that we are going to build fossil or renewables or clean, just the existing ones. We look at this power plant by power plant, factory by factory, heroic work about hundreds of people at the IEA, because it's very important. What we have found out is the existing infrastructure of today, what we have, power plants, factories, buildings, already eat up more than 90% of the emissions allowed to us. So it means we have no allowance to build anything, use anything as of now, many decades, which is not renewables. It means when you leave here, you cannot take a car or a plane. Finished. Unless we intervene and change this picture, the existing infrastructure. And what is the biggest part of the existing infrastructure? It is by far coal and coal in developing Asia. Now, in Germany, we discuss, you discuss, the colleagues here, Kohleausstieg. It is, since months and months, a big discussion. And Minister Altmaier and his team is making a heroic work, hopefully for a successful outcome. Ladies and gentlemen, the German coal, what we are discussing, is about some 40 gigawatts. And we are talking about the 2,000 gigawatts. 2,000 gigawatts. And big chunk of it, this is very important, big chunk of it in the countries where people earn below $2 per capita. $2 per capita. Who will dare to go to Indonesia, to Thailand, to India, to Philippines, to tell the utilities to shut it down, which is providing electricity to the villages? It is not fair. How are we going to compensate this? It's a major issue. Second, in Europe and United States, we have coal plants as well. But those plants are over 42 years old. They are already close to retirement. But in Asia, we have a very young fleet of 11 years old. It didn't pay back. Who is going to finance it? I think this is the major issue. We cannot close our eyes to this reality, the existing lock-in infrastructure. So therefore, in my view, we have two jobs, ladies and gentlemen. One, what we built, new things, should be as sustainable as possible, but it's not enough. Second, we have to intervene the existing unsustainable infrastructure and to make it sustainable. Only doing the first one will not be enough at all. And here, we shouldn't forget the equity issue. Africa is responsible only 1.8% of the CO2 emissions, but gets the biggest hit from the climate change. You have seen what happened in Mozambique very recently. So we have to be very careful there to put both of the challenges in front of us. And International Energy Agency, an agency which looks at all the clean energy technologies, renewables, efficiency, carbon capture and storage, hydrogen. I am just traveling to Japan now. These are all very important technologies. We do not have the luxury to put one aside. I would like to thank the German government once again for inviting the IEA here and finish my words with one appeal to all of you. It's not from the IEA, it is from me. We all have favorite technologies. Some of us like renewables, some of us like wind, solar, hydro, hydrogen power, electric cars. We push that. We push our country's priorities. But the climate change challenge is very big and it is huge. Therefore, I believe it is not the time to boost our egos, but to reduce the CO2 emissions. Thank you very much. Thank you. Thank you.